This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. New York Post is an American daily newspaper, primarily distributed in New York City and its surrounding area. It is the 13th oldest and 7th most widely circulated newspaper in the United States, established in 1801 by Federalist and Founding Father Alexander Hamilton. It became a respected broadsheet in the 19th century. Under the name New York Evening Post, the modern version of the paper is published in tabloid format in 1976. Rupert Murdoch bought Post for $305 million United States dollars since 1993. Post has been owned by News Corporation and its successor, News Corp, which had owned it previously from 1976 to 1988. Its editorial offices are located at 1211th Avenue of the Americas. Contents 1 History 11 19th Century 12 1918 to 1976 13 Murdoch Ownership 131 Style 132 Criticism 133 Controversies 2 Operations 21 Website 22 Highlights 221 Page 6 23 Sales 24 Recent Headquarters 3 Cultural References 4 See also 5 References 6 Further Reading 7 External Links History This section does not cite any sources. Please help improve this section by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. April 2016 Learn how and when to remove this template message. New York Post, established on November 16, 1801 as New York Evening Post, describes itself as the nation's oldest continuously published daily newspaper, the Providence Journal, which began daily publication on July 21, 1829, bills itself as the nation's oldest continuously published daily newspaper because New York Post discontinued publication during strikes in 1958. And 1978 The Hartford Courant, believed to be the oldest continuously published newspaper, was founded in 1764 as a semi-weekly paper. It did not begin publishing daily until 1836. The New Hampshire Gazette, which has trademarked its claim of being the nation's oldest newspaper, was founded in 1756, also as a weekly. Moreover, since the 1890s it has been published only for weekends. 19th century Alexander Hamilton William Cullen Bryant Post was founded by Alexander Hamilton with about $10,000 United States dollars from a group of investors in the autumn of 1801 as New York Evening Post, a broadsheet. Hamilton's co-investors included other New York members of the Federalist Party, such as Robert Troup and Oliver Wolcott, who were dismayed by the election of Thomas Jefferson as U.S. President and the rise in popularity of the Democratic-Republican Party. The meeting at which Hamilton first recruited investors for the new paper took place in the then Country Weekend Villa that is now Gracie Mansion. Hamilton chose William Coleman as his first editor. The most famous 19th-century New York Evening Post editor was the poet and abolitionist William Cullen Bryant. So well-respected was New York Evening Post under Bryant's editorship, it received praise from the English philosopher John Stuart Mill, in 1864. In the summer of 1829, Bryant invited William Leggett, the Locofoco Democrat, to write for the paper there. In addition to literary and drama reviews, Leggett began to write political editorials. Leggett's classical liberal philosophy entailed a fierce opposition to central banking, a support for voluntary labor unions, and a dedication to laissez-faire economics. He was a member of the Equal Rights Party. Leggett became a co-owner and editor at Post in 1831, eventually working as sole editor of the newspaper while Bryant traveled in Europe in 1834 through 1835. Another co-owner of the paper was John Bigelow, born in Malden on Hudson, New York. John Bigelow Sr. graduated in 1835 from Union College, where he was a member of the Sigma Phi Society and the Philomathian Society, and was admitted to the bar in 1838. Citation needed. From 1849 to 1861, he was one of the editors and co-owners of New York Evening Post. In 1881, Henry Villard took control of New York Evening Post, as well as The Nation, which became Post's weekly edition. With this acquisition, the paper was managed by the triumvirate of Carl Schurz, Horace White, and Edwin L. Godkin. When Schurz left the paper in 1883, Godkin became editor-in-chief. White became editor-in-chief in 1899, and remained in that role until his retirement in 1903. In 1897, both publications passed to the management of Villard's son, Oswald Garrison. Villard, a founding member of both the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People and the American Civil Liberties Union 1918-1976. Villard sold the paper in 1918, after widespread allegations of pro-German sympathies during World War I hurt its circulation. The new owner was Thomas Lamont, a senior partner in the Wall Street firm of J.P. Morgan. Under Schiff's tenure, Post was devoted to liberalism, supporting trade unions and social welfare, and featured some of the most popular columnists of the time, such as Joseph Cookman, Drew Pearson, Eleanor Roosevelt, Max Lerner, Murray Kempton, Pete Hamill, and Eric Severide, in addition to theater critic Richard Watts Jr. and Broadway columnist Earl Wilson. Murdoch ownership in 1976, Rupert Murdoch bought Post for $305 million. Post at this point was the only surviving afternoon daily in New York City, and its circulation under Schiff had grown by two-thirds, particularly after the failure of the competing World Journal Tribune. However, the rising cost of operating an afternoon daily in a city with worsening daytime traffic congestion, combined with mounting competition from expanded local radio and competitive newspaper market. In December 2012, Murdoch announced that Jesse Angelo had been appointed publisher-style Headless Body in Topless Bar redirects here for the film. See Headless Body in Topless Bar. One of the paper's most famous headlines, from the April 15, 1983 edition. Murdoch imported the tabloid journalism style of many of his Australian and British newspapers, such as The Sun, which was the highest-selling daily newspaper in the UK for a long time. This style was typified by Post's famous headlines such as Headless Body in Topless Bar, shown on the right, written by Vincent Musetto, who died in June 2015 in its 35th anniversary edition. New York Magazine listed this as one of the greatest headlines. It also has five other Post headlines in its Greatest Tabloid Headlines list because of the institution of federal regulations limiting media cross-ownership after Murdoch's purchase of WNEW-TV, now WNYW-TV, and four other stations from Metro Media to launch the Fox Broadcasting Company. Murdoch was forced to sell the paper for $376 million in 1988 to Peter S. Calico, a real estate magnate with no news experience. When Calico declared bankruptcy in 1993, the paper was temporarily managed by Stephen Hoffenberg, a financier who later pleaded guilty to securities fraud, and, for 2 weeks, by Abe Hirschfeld, who made his fortune building parking garages after a staff revolt against the Hoffenberg-Hirschfeld partnership, which included publication of an issue whose front page featured the iconic masthead photo of founder Alexander Hamilton with a single tear drop running down his cheek. Post was again purchased in 1993 by Murdoch's News Corporation. This came about after numerous political officials, including Democratic Governor of New York Mario Cuomo, persuaded the Federal Communications Commission to grant Murdoch a permanent waiver from the cross-ownership rules that had forced him to sell the paper 5 years earlier. Without that FCC ruling, the paper would have shut down under Murdoch's renewed direction. The paper continued its conservative editorial viewpoint criticism. The Post has been criticized since the beginning of Murdoch's ownership for sensationalism, blatant advocacy, and conservative bias. In 1980, the Columbia Journalism Review stated, "New York Post is no longer merely a journalistic problem, it is a social problem, a force for evil." Perhaps the most serious allegation against the Post is that it is willing to contort its news coverage to suit Murdoch's business needs, in particular that the paper has avoided reporting anything that is unflattering to the government of the People's Republic of China, where Murdoch has invested heavily, and satellite television critics say that the Post allows its editorial positions to shape its story selection and news coverage. Former Post executive editor Stephen D. Quozzo has responded that the Post broke the elitist media stranglehold on the national agenda. According to a survey conducted by Pace University in 2004, the Post was rated the least credible major news outlet in New York, and the only news outlet to receive more responses calling it not credible than credible. 44% not credible to 39% credible. The Public Enemy song, A Letter to the New York Post, from their album Apocalypse 91, The Enemy Strikes Black, is a complaint about what they believed to be negative and inaccurate coverage blacks received from the paper. The Post's coverage of the murder of Hasidic landlord Menachem Stark prompted outrage from Jewish communal leaders and public figures. Controversies. This article's criticism or controversy section may compromise the article's neutral point of view of the subject. Please integrate the section's contents into the article as a whole, or rewrite the material. September 2015. There have been numerous controversies surrounding Post. On September 21, 1995, 1979, a large page one headline read, "The Beatles are back," with the subheadline, "Fab Four reunited for big UN concert in New York, The Beatles never reunited," and no retraction, apology, or acknowledgement of incorrect information was published. In 1997, a national news story concerning Rebecca Seelfon's victory in the Scripps National Spelling Bee circulated. Seelfon was sponsored by the Daily News. A direct in-market competitor Post published a picture of her but altered the photograph to remove the name of the Daily News as printed on a placard she was wearing on November 8, 2000. Post printed, "Bush wins," in a huge headline, although the presidential election remained in doubt because of the recount needed in Florida. Like Post, many other newspapers around the country published a similar headline after the four major TV networks called the election for George W. Bush on March 10, 2004. Post re-ran, as a full-color page one photograph, a photograph that had already been run 3 days earlier in black and white on page nine, showing the 24-story suicide plunge of a New York University student, who had since been identified as 19-year-old Diana Cheehan, daughter of a prominent Silicon Valley businessman. Among criticisms leveled at Post was their addition of a tightly cropped inset photograph of Cheehan, a former high school track athlete, depicting her in mid-jump from an athletic meet, giving the false impression that it was taken during her fatal act, despite the fact that she had fallen face up on July 6, 2004. Post ran an article claiming to have learned exclusively that Senator John Kerry, the Democratic Party's presidential nominee in waiting, had selected former House Minority Leader Dick Gephardt to be the party's vice presidential nominee. The article, under the headline "Kerry's Choice," ran without a byline the next day. Post had to print a new story, "Kerry's Real Choice," reporting Kerry's actual selection of Senator John Edwards of North Carolina as his running mate on April 21, 2006. Several Asian American advocacy groups protested the use of the headline "Walk This Way" for a Post article about Bush's meeting with the Hu Jintao, president of the People's Republic of China, on September 29, 2006. Post editor Sarah Polonsky was fired abruptly for accepting gifts on September 27, 2006. Post published an article called "Powder Puff Spooks Keith" that made fun of Countdown host Keith Olbermann receiving an anthrax threat from an unknown terrorist on December 7, 2006. Post doctored a front-page photograph to depict the co-chairman of the Iraq Study Group, James Baker and Lee Hamilton, in primate fur, under the headline "Surrender Monkeys," inspired by a once-used line from The Simpsons in defense of the "Surrender Monkeys" headline. Media contributor Simon Dumenko wrote an Ad Age article about his love for Post on February 18, 2009. Post ran a cartoon by Sean Delonis that depicted a white police officer saying to another white police officer who has just shot a chimpanzee on the street, "They'll have to find someone else to write the next stimulus bill." The cartoon duly referred to President Obama and to the recent rampage of Travis, a former chimpanzee actor. It was criticized as being in bad taste, primarily by making a reference to the racist stereotype of African Americans being portrayed as apes. Civil rights activist Al Sharpton called the cartoon troubling at best, given the historic racist attacks of African Americans as being synonymous with monkeys. Post has defended itself by stating that the cartoon was deliberately misinterpreted by its critics. On December 4, 2012, Post used a picture taken by a freelance photographer, R. Umar Abbasi, of a 58-year-old man identified as Ki Suk Han struggling to climb back up onto the platform of the 49th Street station as a subway train approached. The caption on the front read, "Pushed on the subway track, this man is about to die on top, and doomed," in large, boldface print on the bottom. The image caused outrage among many, as its use was viewed as exploiting a tragedy for commercial gain, though Abbasi stated that since he was not strong enough to pull the man up, he had attempted to use the flash on his camera to alert the driver of the oncoming train. Aspects of Post's coverage of the 2013 Boston Marathon bombing were criticized. Post reported in several stories on the day of the attack that the death toll was 12, while most organizations reported two and then three fatalities in addition. They reported that a Saudi national was being held as a suspect, but Boston police denied this and said they had no suspects in custody. Additionally, the April 18 cover of Post featured a full-page photo of two young men the paper described as being sought by law enforcement in possible connection with the attack. CBS News reporter John Miller reported that the two men are not considered suspects by the FBI. The apparent insinuation by Post that they were suspects suspects was denounced by media critics in June 2013. The two men, Salaheddin Barhoum and Yassin Zaimi, sued Post for libel over the story in 2014. The suit was settled on January 5, 2014. Following the abduction and murder of Brooklyn businessman Menachem Stark, Post cover story featured a picture of the victim dressed in his traditional Hasidic garb, accompanied by the headline asking, "Who didn't want him dead?" That front page sparked outrage for its insinuation that the murder was justified vigilantism on that same day. Some New York City elected officials condemned Post's cover story in a press conference led by Brooklyn Borough President Eric Adams. New York City public advocate Letitia James declared, "Today, given license to murder," James then asked that "every government official should refrain from advertising in the New York Post, every government official should withdraw any governmental notice from the New York Post, and everyone should condemn the New York Post." Post and the Daily News often take potshots at each other's work and accuracy, particularly in their respective gossip page items in certain editions of the February 14, 2007, newspaper. An article referring to then-Senator Hillary Clinton's support base for her 2008 presidential run referred to then-Senator Barack Obama as Osama. The paper realized its error and corrected it for the later editions, and the website Post noted the error and apologized in the February 15, 2007, edition earlier. On January 20, 2007, Post received some criticism for running a potentially misleading headline, "Osama Mud Flies at Obama," for a story that discussed rumors that Obama had been raised as a Muslim and concealed at Operations website printing plant in 1996. Post launched an internet version of the paper. The original site included color photos and sections broken down into news, sports, editorial, gossip, entertainment, and business. It also had an archive for the past 7 days. Since then, it has been redesigned a number of times, with the latest incarnation launched on September 6, 2009. In 2005, the website implemented a registration requirement but removed it in July 2006. The current website also features continually updated breaking news, entertainment, business, and sports blogs, links to Page Six magazine, photo and video galleries, original Post videos, user-submitted photos and comments, and streaming video for live events highlights. The paper is well known for its sports section, which has been praised for its comprehensiveness. It begins on the back page, and among other coverage, contains columns about sports in the media by Phil Mushnick. New York Post is also well known for its gossip columnist Cindy Adams. Page Six. Page Six redirects here for the Atari Computer magazine. See Page 6. The best known gossip section is Page 6. It was created by James Brady and currently edited by Emily Smith, although it no longer actually appears on Page 6 of the tabloid. February 2006 saw the debut of Page 6 magazine, distributed free inside the paper in September 2007. It started to be distributed weekly in the Sunday edition of the paper in January 2009. Publication of Page 6 magazine was cut to 4 times a year. Sales. The daily circulation of Post decreased in the final years of the Schiff era from 700,000 in the late 1960s to approximately 418,000 by the time she sold the paper to Murdoch in 1976. Under Murdoch, Post launched a morning edition to compete directly with the rival tabloid Daily News in 1978, prompting the Daily News to retaliate with a PM edition called Daily News Tonight. But the PM edition suffered the same problems with worsening daytime traffic that the Afternoon Post experienced, and the Daily News ultimately folded Tonight in 1981. By that time, circulation of the all-day Post soared to a peak of 962,000, the bulk of the increase attributed to its morning edition. It set a single-day record of 11 million on August 11, 1977, with the news of the arrest the night before of David Berkowitz, the infamous Son of Sam serial killer who terrorized New York for much of that summer. But Post lost so much money that Murdoch decided to shut down Post's PM edition in 1982, turning Post into a morning-only Daily Post, and the Daily News have been locked in a bitter circulation war ever since. A resurgence during the first decade of the 21st century saw Post circulation rise to 724,748 by April 2007, achieved partly by lowering the price from 50 cents to 25 cents in October 2006, Post for the first time surpassed the Daily News in circulation, only to see the Daily News overtake its rival a few months later. As of April 2010, Post's daily circulation is 525,004, just 10,000 behind the Daily News. Yet Post has remained unprofitable since Murdoch first purchased it from Dorothy Schiff in 1976, and was on the brink of folding when Murdoch bought it back in 1993, with at least one media report in 2012 indicating that Post loses up to $70 million a year. One commentator has suggested that Post cannot become profitable as long as the competing Daily News survives, and that Murdoch may be trying to force the Daily News to fold or sell out recent headquarters. The 1906 Old New York Evening Post building is a designated landmark. It was added to the National Register of Historic Places in 1977. It occupied the building until 1926, when a new main office for the Post was established at 75 West Street in the New York Evening Post building. The building remained in use by the Post until 1970. It was added to the National Register of Historic Places in 2000. In 1967, Schiff bought 210 South Street, the former headquarters of the New York Journal American, which closed a year earlier. The building became an instantly recognizable symbol for the Post. In 1995, owner Rupert Murdoch relocated Post's news and business offices to the News Corporation headquarters tower at 1211th Avenue of the Americas. 6th Avenue in Midtown Manhattan. Post shares this building with Fox News Channel and the Wall Street Journal, both of which are also owned by Murdoch. Post and the New York City edition of the Journal are printed at a state-of-the-art printing plant in the borough of the Bronx. Cultural references. Vincent Musetto's 1983 headline inspired Peter Koper to write the 1995 American black comedy Headless Body and Topless Bar. See also Journalism Portal. New York City Portal. Media of New York City. References. Carat AB FAS Fax Report. Circulation averages for the 6 months ended March 31, 2012. Arlington Heights, IL. Audit Bureau of Circulations retrieved May 21, 2012. Carat ABC Emery. Carat Deborah G. Felder. Carat ABC Neil Hickey. January to February 2004. Moment of Truth. Columbia Journalism Review. Archived from the original on April 23, 2007. Retrieved June 7, 2007. Broadcast News. PDF Pace Poll Survey Research Study. Retrieved June 7, 2007. Carat NY Post. February 19, 2009. That Cartoon. New York Post. Retrieved February 2, 2009. Original on December 7, 2013. Retrieved February 13, 2014. York Times Blog. Retrieved June 7, 2007. 2016. Nardoza, Robert. Long-time Bonanno Organized Crime Family. Soldiers Baldassare Amato and Stephen Licurto, and Bonanno Crime Family Associate Anthony Basile, convicted of racketeering conspiracy. The United States Attorney's Office, Eastern District of New York. Press release July 12, 2006. Accessed June 5, 2008. The People of the State of New York, v. Richard Cantarella, Frank Cantarella, Anthony Michel, Vincent Desario, Corey Ellenthal, Michael Fago, Gerard Bilboa, Anthony Terzio, Penal Law, a web. Accessed June 5, 2008. Robbins, Tom, The Newspaper Racket, Tough Guys and Wise Guys in the Truck Drivers Union. The Village Voice, March 7-13, 2001. Accessed June 5, 2008. External links. Official website. VE Current White House. James S. Brady Press Briefing Room. Seating Chart. Row Podium 1-2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, N, B, C. News Wall Street, Journal Agence France Press Foreign Pool Bloomberg BNA Washington Examiner Talk Radio News Service Fox News CBS Radio News USA Today MSNBC Time Yahoo News Dallas Morning News CBS News Bloomberg McClatchy Washington Times NY Daily News Salem Radio Roll Call AP NPRAURN The Hill Hearst, SF Cron, Balt Sun Media News, Daily Beast CBN ABC News Washington Post Politico Fox News Radio NY Post Christian Sci Monitor BBC, Boston Globe Reuters NY Times Tribune VOA RealClear Politics SiriusXM Scripps, BuzzFeed CNN AP Radio ABC News Radio National Journal Chicago Sun Times, Al Jazeera Dow Jones Financial Times, The Guardian. The seating chart as of March 25, 2015 White House Correspondents Association VE News Corp VE Dow Jones. The Wall Street Journal Europe Wall Street Journal Radio Network WSJ Enterprise Products Factiva S. Newmarket Press United Kingdom William Collins, Sons Collins Bartholomew The Friday Project Leckie. News Corp Australia Metropolitan Newspapers The Australian The Daily Telegraph Herald Sun, Sunday Herald Sun The Courier Mail The Sunday Mail Brisbane The Advertiser The Sunday Times Western Australia The Mercury Northern Territory News MX Community Newspapers Leader Community Newspapers Victoria Newslocal NSW Quest Community Newspapers Queensland Messenger Newspapers South Australia Community Newspaper Group Western Australia Regional Newspapers Geelong Advertiser Gold Coast Bulletin The Cairns Post Townsville Bulletin Magazines Big League GQ Australia Vogue Australia Fox Sports Thai Limited Fox Sports Fox Footy Fox Sports News Professional Sports Brisbane Broncos 6887% Other Properties Australian Associated Press 45% Newspoll Polling Brand Papua New Guinea Post Courier 63% Ray Group 616% Foxtel 50% VE News UK The Times The Sunday Times The Sun The Times Literary Supplement Other Assets Move New York Post News America Marketing News Outdoor Group See also List of assets owned by News Corp, 21st Century Fox, News Corporation v. E. Alexander Hamilton Senior Officer of the United States Army, 1799-1801, Secretary of the Treasury, 1789-1795 Delegate, Congress of the Confederation, 1782-1783, 1788-1789 United States Founding Events A Full Vindication of the Measures of Congress 1774 The Farmer Refuted 1775 Delegate, 1786 Annapolis Convention Delegate, 1787 Constitutional Convention initiated, main author, The Federalist Papers written by Hamilton Founding Father Secretary of the Treasury First Bank of the United States Revenue Marine United States Coast Guard. United States Customs Service Hamiltonian Economic Program Residence Act Compromise of 1790 First Report on the Public Credit, 1790 Funding Act of 1790 Operations of the Act Laying Duties on Imports, 1790 Second Report on Public Credit, a.k.a. Report on a National Bank, 1790 Report on Manufactures, 1791 Tariff of 1790 Tariff of 1792 Coinage Act of 1792 United States Mint Whiskey Rebellion J. Treaty Military Career New York Provincial Company of Artillery in the Revolutionary War.